as well, just to really up the love ante music. We can be single together. You can't be single together. We are independently single. This music is overpowering me. Here we go. That's better. All right. We're celebrating in the conventional way. Arguably, you're more single when you're playing a quiz. That is true. More single, potentially. I went to the shop before, and I love buying love hearts. And I bought these, but I've realised they're actually called kind hearts. But normally they're called love hearts. And each one, I don't know if they're quite popular worldwide, I think they are, but they have a love message on each sweet that you can read out. So, who should we go first? Omni wins, I forgot to study our animatics. Cinematic Killers covers. Exactly. Can't go wrong with Mr. Brightside. Your wife and I play Raw the Weekend when she isn't working. Oh, that's nice. I wish I had someone to play more trivia with. Oh, well, Conversation Hearts in the US. Okay. This one doesn't have a message. It just has a smiley face on. Oh, you can't see that. Oh, well. I'll just eat. This one's giving me the bright side. Good question. I have bad reception. Oh, no. It might be all right, though. I do find out. We've made some improvements, so it should be a bit easier to play through. We've got a few more updates coming out this week as well. Are they like Necco wafers? What are Necco wafers? Tim, you can play with Joe and our host, lol. I think Joe already has someone. Joe has someone to play with. I don't know what you're implying. Play the quiz. You can host the quiz. I see. That's what you mean. What are Necco wafers? I need to Google that right now to see. Necco wafers. Oh, yeah. They do look like that, don't they? They're not that, though. I love Necco wafers. They're like chalky. These are also chalky. Who would like a love heart dedicated to them? I'll tell you what it says. Wow. This one says wild thing. Someone's a wild thing. Dot, you're the wild thing. There you go. If you can, you can't read them. They're too bright. There you go, wild thing. Epic. You want one. Epic, apparently you're all mine. This one says all mine. Wow. Sentimental today. I'm going to cry as we go through this quiz and the music plays. 64 people in. Howdy, Jeff Keys, never. I love Rennie. The thing for heartburn, PL jogging. I mean, that does make sense. Hello, Ben. Reese's peanut butter hearts. Oh, they sound good. New England Confectionery Co. I should have known that. Well, we're not New England, are we? I'm just England here. Wow. Well, welcome everyone for playing. Who've you got in chat? Lots of people. Call people out. Loose Noodle, I have seen your message and your feedback form thing you sent us, and we will wear that out, what you requested, and going through there as well. So just to let you know, we saw it, because I can see you're in chat. Hello from Taiwan, how's it going? Hopefully Taiwan having a good Valentine's Day. Right, we are 70 people in, and I think we're ready to start some trivia. If you don't know, it's your first time, my name is Tim. And we're going to do 5 quick questions. The quicker you answer, the more points you get. Let's look at the leaderboards to see how much money you can win. In first place, you'll get £10 and 1,000 stubs. Second place, £5, 750 stubs. Sixth place, or third place, £2.50 and 500. And fourth, fifth, and sixth, £1 and 100 stubs. Why did you just get 81 stubs, says Ben? Well, you get 80 stubs from joining a stream a day, and you get one stub for every minute you watch. So 81 minutes. That's why you've got 81 there. There you go. If I remember correctly how they're dished out. Right. Let's go for our first wonderful Valentine's Day question. Now, there is a theme of today's questions. I don't know if you'll be able to guess what it is, but you might be able to see. So, question one. Cupid is the god of love, candy, or arrows. Cupid, famous for one of these things. You guys will explain at the end of the stream. That's good. Is streaming okay? It seems to be okay for me. Is the theme candy? It should be. The correct answer is, in fact, love. Cupid is the god of love. and everyone got that correct. Well done. No one went for candy, no one for arrows. He does carry arrows, though, and Cupid is, in fact, the son of Venus. So, there we go. Question one completed. Question number... Who's the god of candy? I don't know. I've got candy here, but I hate listening to people eat on streams, so I'm not gonna put you guys through that. Listening to me, I'm the god of candy. I should be. There we go. Mars, god of war. Question two. New song. What country should you go to visit? What country should you visit to go to the city of love? Is it Italy, France, or Spain? Where is the city of love? And why aren't I there now? Italti. Oh my god, I did spell Italy wrong. It's not that one anyway though, so it's fine. Italti. Wow. Love is not in my spelling. Thanks, word spell checker. Nice new background. It is. It's a love background. The correct answer is not America. It is France. 52 going for that, 17 going for Italti, 0 going for Spain. So the city of love, if you didn't know, is in fact Paris. And you might be wondering, why is Paris known as the City of Love? Well, in fact, the Romantic era of art, where it took place at the end of the 18th century, and it's basically where artists depict their emotions and expressionism, rather than like what it actually is. A fun quote about Romanticism. Romanticism lies neither in the subjects that an artist chooses, nor his exact copying of the truth, but the way he feels. Romanticism and modern art are one of the same things. In other words, intimacy, spirituality, colour, yearning for the infinite, expressed by all the means that arts possess. So, there you go. Yeah, it went from being literal to metaphysical art. Isn't that fun? But that is why France is known as the City of Love. Let's look at the leaderboards. You're late. Don't worry. You can still catch up, potentially. Andrew's in the lead with 19k, followed by Best Ken Ever, Aaron-O-Matics, Ollie in fourth, Neatly Done fifth, Year of the Tiger at sixth, and Dav31 in seventh. Anime Dan, I do fan out, Gary, Ferg27, Marky54. A lot of people on 19k. In fact, all the way down to, like, 29. So, like, you have to press quick on these questions to get through. Every day is an education. That's good. We all learn. Right, 19.4 at 21st. Oof. People are quick tapping. Right, I'll try and make it easier. Not really, I can't do that. But you can just answer quicker, hopefully. Which of these does not mean I love you? Is it TMO? Is it Je t'aime? Or is it Dankeschön? I just told 74 people that I love them. That's nice. The correct answer. Well, and then one. I didn't say that. The correct answer is, in fact, Dankeschön, which is not love. That is actually German for thank you very much. So if someone Dankeschöns you, it's not as much as love. Right. We're getting through the first three. On to the harder questions now. I love you. Oh my God. You love Papa Smurf. I love Papa Smurf. Ah, so much love. So much love today in chat for this lonely Valentine's Day. Question number four. I think of Ferris Bueller. I get what you mean. Love, as well as being a abstract concept thing that we try and work out, is also a very physical thing. So what is known as the love hormone? Is it oxytocin, testosterone, or serotonin? Now, they say they can't bottle love, but they can bottle oxytocin, which is also known as the love hormone. 39 if you're getting that right, 3 for testosterone, 26 for serotonin. There are many things that can boost your serotonin, love probably being one of them, but unfortunately it's not known as the love drug. So, oxytocin is actually produced in the hypothalamus and is released into the bloodstream through your pituitary gland. And the main function of it is to facilitate childbirth. So what it does is it stimulates the muscles of the uterus to contract and boosts the production of prostaglandins. Oh, prostaglandins, I can't pronounce that. Which also increases uterine contractions. So if a woman's labour is slow to go through, it also, sometimes they give them oxytocin because it'll help speed them up. And also, when you're excited by a sexual partner or you fall in love, it also produces oxytocin. So that's why it's called the love hormone, or as this article puts it, the cuddle hormone as well. So if you have the love or cuddle hormone, it's oxytocin. There you go. I wonder if you just like inject yourself with a load of oxytocin, whether you just start loving people and things. I don't know how that would work. Then again, there's probably other drugs for that. You're going to have to explain all these to me. I'm more of a dopamine guy. Makes sense. I'm learning so much this morning. I think about eating pizza. That's good. What's the air quotes? Just in air quotes. Sexual partners, isn't it? Right, let's look at the leaderboards before we get into the last of our love-themed questions. Well, our first love-themed quiz of the day. We've got one later. Andrew's in first place, followed by Neatly Done, Now Cut That Out, Nova Steven, Mark, Year of the Tiger in sixth, and Gary in seventh. Stephanie, I Do Fan Art, Mist, Mrs. 12, James, Tigers, Ryan the Scion, Miguel, Hutch, Ben. Coming close. You're near. You're late, Joe. Ah, don't worry. There's some love everywhere around. Right, question five. We're almost there. Last one for money. And it's, again, another love question. Who said, 'tis better to have loved and lost than to have never have loved at all? Is it Mark Twain, Charles Dickens, or Alfred Lord Tennyson? Cupid has oxytocin in his arrows. He probably does, yeah. He shoots you with oxytocin, you instantly fall in love. Or if you're a woman in labour, you start giving labour quicker. I Do Fan Art, F-wording hard in chat, probably not the same oxycontin. I kept saying oxycontin when I was reading it. The correct answer is Alfred Lord Tennyson, who is out. He said that about his dead mate. That's not good. 34 you're going for that, 18 for Charles Dickens. Mark Twain, 11th, you know. Well, Alfred was in fact British, which is good. The line he actually said was, "I hold it true, whatever befall. I feel it when I sorrow most. 'Tis better to have loved and lost than never to have loved at all." Ah, what nice words. I tried to look at the whole poem, but it was too long to read on stream, so I thought I'd just read one. And yeah, Tennyson was incredibly popular, but over time, people started to not like him in the 20th century because they thought his style was overly sentimental, too moralistic, and people were just got a bit more like, I don't know, people got a bit more brutal. Whoop, I got a fat zero too early. Unlucky, Papa Smith. You teared up. It's hot. Right. Last question. I thought it was from a Shakespeare play. It would make sense if it was. You got the oxytocin question right. That's good. You know love, the chemical formula for love. We're going to keep reading fat as fart this morning. Stop reading fart. Right, let's look at the final leaderboards for our first love quiz of the day. It is Andrew's in first place, followed by Nova Steven, followed by Marky, Now Cut Out, Year the Tiger, Gary, and we're at 74, so Stephanie 13 will also take home a prize today. Well done, everyone, for playing. That was tight. I think a lot of people got the four questions right, five questions right as well. It's just all with the times. That's good. Well done. And we'll now send out our winner's pop-up to those top seven players. And we're not done with Valentine's Day. I'll be back in, what's the time now? 5 hours-ish. And we'll do our round two of love Valentine's Day quizzing. That'll be fun. Epic fail for me. Nice to the winners, though. It's all right, Denzel, don't worry. To finish off, I'll open one of my kind hearts, my last kind hearts, to see what the message is. It just says love you. Isn't that nice? That's good. Right. Thank you, everyone, for playing. Thanks for the fun, definitely. Hopefully you learned something. Happy Valentine's Day, and we'll be back again in 5 hours for Valentine's 2, the return of more Valentine's Day questions, and maybe one about something else, but probably mostly Valentine's Day. 30 off from a nice finish. That's so close. Goodbye all. Enjoy the rest of your Valentine's Day and be back with us at 8 p.m. or whatever time is where you are. And yeah, we'll play again. Goodbye. Enjoy. Ooh.